I'm Cal. Welcome to another video. In this video I want to divert slightly from my previous series, the Budget Gaming Build series. The link is above my head for that series, right about here somewhere. For now, I want to concentrate on improving old or using old in new ways to make the best of what we currently have before you think of spending money unnecessarily. I think most people have an old laptop lying around, maybe for casual internet browsing, or maybe you have one as your current go-to PC. Is yours getting too slow for the internet? Does it take minutes to boot up? Are you thinking of buying a new one? Are you thinking of throwing your current one away? Would it be good if you could breathe new life into what you currently have, save you money on buying a new one, or use it for something else rather than throwing it away? If you answered yes to any of these questions, stay tuned to this new series of videos, How to Improve Your Tired Laptop. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for future videos in this series and others. Now, I'm not promising we can do this in all cases, but hopefully we can utilise what you currently have. You will have to do most of the homework yourself. Not all laptops are the same. My laptop is a Lenovo G710. I bought it around 4 years ago for a main computer. This is before I knew what I know now. Otherwise, I would have steered clear, built something better myself. I digress though. Here are the specs for it. Windows 10 Home, Pentium processor. Yes, Pentium. Not even an i bloody 3. Saw me coming, didn't they? 6GB of RAM. The only change I've made to this PC since I've got it is upgrade it from Windows 8.1 to Windows 10, or should I say forced, which I am grateful for. 8.1 was not very good. I did a quick Google search for the processor and this is what the response was. Inexpensive dual core, 2013. Yes, they definitely saw me coming. This is what the Lenovo website had to say. Oh, no longer available. Nice. Oh, lowest grade of CPU with mine. Yes, they definitely saw me coming. I've had enough of this. This laptop took minutes to boot up. Internet surfing wasn't great either. I thought that was normal for a laptop. This is it now, in real time, booting up after I've altered a few components. Now remember, inexpensive dual core 2013, which I haven't changed. Lowest CPU in the range for the G10s. This is a fresh install of Windows and I haven't put a password on it, but wow, how long was that? About 20 seconds? From turn on to surfing the net. How quick is your so-called modern laptop? Inexpensive dual core, remember? 6-year-old tech. Not bad, eh? I have done 3 things to this laptop, which will split into at least 2 different videos, due to them being showing you how to do these videos. I need to keep them short. We'll just go back to the last video before my outburst. This is where you will have to do your homework. Currently has 6GB of RAM on board, but up to 16GB DDR3 1600MHz. Up to 1TB storage for HDD, or 1TB SSHD, which means 2.5-inch form factor drive. This page indicates to me that I can upgrade the RAM and also improve on the hard disk drive. You will have to look up your laptop specs and see if you're limited to what you can do. In this video, I'm going to show you how to upgrade the RAM. I have this 16GB RAM kit spare. It was from another laptop, which I thought was good enough to be my main PC as well. It wasn't. It couldn't even run Office and it died a death as soon as the guarantee ran out. At this moment in time, do not go out and buy RAM. Find out your laptop specs to see if it is possible and price it up by all means, but the alteration to the hard disk in the second video may be all that you need. I might have looked up prices on CEX or Amazon, but I had this RAM kit spare already. It was doing nothing. Do not fork out yet. Watch the second video first. Again, price things up first to see if this is a practical solution or not. I will try and publish the next video in about a week's time. This is kind of like the budget build series, as we're thinking of budget things to do with your already owned equipment. But we will have to see if it's practical or possible first. Here's my video. You will have to look on the internet to see how to get into your laptop, but mine is pretty easy. Some are not. Before you open the case, remove the battery first. All I need to do is remove two screws from the back of the case, one here and another one here. Some manufacturers hide their screws under the pads of the feet, or worse, only allow access through the front via the keyboard. I would not recommend you doing this if you're a novice. You will have to decide though.
So first of all, before you start doing anything with the laptop, make sure you take the battery out. So it's got a locking mechanism here. You need to go red and then you press this one and then the battery should just come out. So make sure you don't drop or bang this. So I'll put it to one side. And then what we'll do is just take out the actual screws themselves.
Some laptops have screws underneath the battery compartment. Do your research first. Seriously, don't just get out your screwdriver and think, how hard can this be?
And then this is going to be two. Sorry about me having Robin Williams arms, but there we go. That's what we're blessed with. There's one. And then another one. So it's just two screws. Once we've done this, all we need to do is just pull it towards us and that slides off. There we go. Off. So we got is the RAM itself. So all we need to do is just see these two little pincers here, just pull them apart slightly. There we go, pops out, and then we just pull the RAM out. Sure, it goes in this side and it goes in one way. Lock, put that to one side, and then we've got another further stick of RAM underneath this. So what we're gonna do is just pull them to one side. There we go, and then this just slides out. Easy peasy. So we got, make sure that the RAM here is here and this fits into this little bit here. So what we do is just slide it in. There we go. So it's in that way. What we do is just push it down. See these two little things snap in? Didn't know all that going on. There we go. There we go, and just snap it in. There we go, all in nice and tight. Pop that in, two screws. Put them in all the way. Just make sure you don't cross the thread. Until there's a little bit more. And then this one. And a lock. So when you do this one, there we go. All good.
There we go then. That was pretty simple on mine, wasn't it? This was only a RAM upgrade though. If you do this, you will see a nice improvement when you're doing tasks. I would recommend having at least 8 GB these days, especially to run Windows 10 efficiently. The next video, however, is where you will see the biggest improvement. So stay tuned. Please like, share, subscribe, and ask others to do the same. I do this as a hobby, and I do need your encouragement. Even leaving a comment spurs me on. Seriously, don't be shy. So I'm not too sure whether you heard me moaning about my previous choices of laptops and feeling ripped off, but this is the real reason why I started researching and learning about modern computer components. I suggest you do the same before you buy anything. Check out my previous videos from the Modern Budget Gaming PC series. They may open your eyes onto something you haven't thought of. Hitting the red subscribe button doesn't cost you anything. If you're unsure of things or how to navigate YouTube, watch this previous video I made. It's for smartphones, but there's similar features for the PC as well. I'll leave a link in the description below. Thank you, current subscribers and Facebook friends, for your likes and shares, and to the people that say thank you in the video description. If you found this video helpful or interesting, show your appreciation, like it, subscribe, add your feelings on the subject in the comment section below. If you know someone new to computers, share my videos with them and point them in my direction. I have learning videos that are very basic for people new to the scene. I will be making more Windows ones soon to come. Thanks for watching. I'm Calm Cal. Have a good morning, afternoon, or good evening. Farewell till next time, and I'll see you later.